Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can build your own automated product feedback AI analyst using Make and ChatGPT. Now these days, collecting customer feedback is pretty straightforward, but when you're receiving hundreds, thousands, or even millions of feedback responses from your customers, actually finding the time to process this feedback can seem impossible. So in this video, I'll guide you through how we can use AI to analyze feedback at scale and identify the most pressing pain points and needs from your customers, saving you hours of time and helping you make informed decisions. Now, if you're new to the channel, my name is Yan. I'm one of the co-founders of 9X. And at 9X, we train business professionals in AI and automation. We've already trained more than 2,000 business operators in how they can leverage this new technology to improve the way they work. And regularly on this YouTube channel, we release these AI and automation tutorials. So if you always want to be informed when the next tutorial drops, please make sure to subscribe to our channel. So for this tutorial, we actually have some fictional data prepared for you in a Google Sheet. And this is some customer feedback for a made up photo app called iSnap. And basically what iSnap do is whenever someone cancels their subscription, they ask them to provide a little bit of feedback. And that is the data that you'll see here. So this is data from feedback that users are giving when they cancel their subscription. If you want to actually follow along and build this tutorial with me, we have a full written tutorial which shows you how to set this up step by step, where you'll also find a copy of this spreadsheet that you can duplicate and also any prompts that we use later in the automated workflow. So to automate this whole process, we're going to be using the integration platform Make. So basically Make is a workflow builder that allows you to build visually and connect thousands of different apps, whether that's Google Sheets, Gmail, Salesforce, HubSpot. They've got integrations with thousands of different platforms. And Make is also one of the best ways to build powerful AI-based workflows. They do actually have a free plan, which you can use, but also even better, in the description below, we have a special link where you can get 1 month for free on their pro plan, which will give you 10K operations, which is more than enough for you to play around and get started. So now here we are in our Make scenario, and what this one's gonna do, it's gonna take the data, all that feedback from the Google Sheet, run it through ChatGPT, and then basically share the results to us directly via email, and I'll walk you through this now step by step. So the way we get started is with a Google Sheets module, and we're using the search rows action. So here in Make, we have the different Google Sheets actions, and the one we're using is just search rows. The way this one is set up, so I've connected it to my Google Sheets account and found that spreadsheet, so the iSnap photo app churn feedback table. Now in that sample set of data, we've just got like one set of, I think, 32 bits of feedback. Imagine if you had a Google Sheet where you're actually already logging all of your feedback, and it's just basically adding to this sheet. What you can very easily do is also add a filter here to say, hey, only show me the data from the previous week. And then you can have this run every Monday. And so every Monday you'd receive this churn analysis directly to your email. You can easily do that here with a filter. But in our case, we're just grabbing all of that data from the Google Sheet. So the way this one looks, if we take a look here at the results, so we have now what are known as bundles. So what this Google Sheets action has done is gone and retrieved all of the rows from our Google Sheet. And we can see we have up to 32 rows, so 32 pieces of feedback. And the way that Make works is whenever you have a module that spits out these bundles, whatever's going to happen afterwards in the scenario will happen once for each bundle. And that's not something that we obviously want, because we don't want ChatGPT to analyze each one of these individually and send an email for each of the 32 feedback. We want ChatGPT to read through all of this feedback and then do one analysis. So one useful tool that we have in Make is what is known as the text aggregator. And the way you find that is down here in tools, you can either scroll through or just search for text and you'll see it there, text aggregator. So what it does is it aggregates multiple strings into one text. And the way this one is set up, let me just click out of this. and we can have a look. So whenever you have an aggregation module in Make, so this could be aggregating to a JSON or aggregating to array, or in this case, aggregating to text, you need to select the source module. And the source module is gonna be, what's the module in the scenario that's creating these many bundles? And in our case, it's this Google Sheets module here, which I've named Get Customer Feedback. So I can just go ahead and map this. And now it's asking me for each bundle in this Google Sheets module, how do you want me to separate the rows? And in my case, I want this to be on a new row so that every, in this text output that we have, every bit of feedback is gonna be on a new line. If you have multiple line feedback, maybe you might make this different. Maybe it's gonna be a tab or a comma, but in our case, we're just gonna have this on a new row. And then which text do I wanna aggregate? And all I've done here is basically mapped the feedback column into this text box here. So what we can do in Make is always map any data from a previous step into the next step. So all we're saying here is, hey, take the feedback from each row and just put it out into one string, one after the other. So let's take a look at the results of that. So we can see here we had 32 bundles coming in, but the output is only one bundle. And this is one large text where we have each piece of feedback on a new row, and text is the perfect format to now put this into a large language model like ChatGPT and have it analyze it. And that is exactly what we've done. So we've dropped in our ChatGPT app here, and from the different options that we have, the one we're using is this create a completion, so bracket prompt. And the way you can think about this is just how you would prompt ChatGPT using the user interface when you're working with it yourself. You can now, in an automated workflow, also fire off a prompt and get ChatGPT to give you a response. And this is what's known as creating a completion. And so the way we've set this one up is I can go into the app configuration here. So the model we're using is ChatGPT 4.0. And here I have my prompt. And as I mentioned, you'll also find a copy of this prompt in the tutorial. And I'll actually go over there now and walk you through this step by step. So here we have the prompt published on our website in the tutorial. And so all we're asking it to do, we're telling ChatGPT, hey, you're tasked with analyzing customer feedback for this photo app. And what we're going to do is in between these, what are known as delimiters, pass through dynamically all of that feedback. So all that text that we previously aggregated. And these delimiters are very useful when working with specifically dynamic data and prompting an LLM or an AI, because it's a great way that the AI knows, okay, this is where the customer feedback starts and this is where the customer feedback ends. And now the rest of the prompt continues, because you never know what dynamic data could be passed in there. So this is really useful when potentially putting in like long strings, injecting long strings into a prompt. Now we're giving it the specific instructions on how it should perform this analysis. And then lastly, what our prompt's doing is it's telling it exactly how we want the output of the response. So we want it to create a summary here, and we're asking it to give the top 5 reasons for cancellation, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And we've told it to basically separate using these line breaks. And this is the format that's going to be basically being able to pass directly into that email module in the last step. If you're not sending this via email, but rather you're sending it via Slack, or you want it maybe saved in a Google Doc, you will need to adjust this format. But for our case, sending it to email, this format is perfect. Now, just a quick break from the tutorial. If you are new to the world of automation and AI, we've actually prepared a free crash course, which just takes 3 hours to complete. If you're interested, I'll leave a link in the description below. So looking at the prompt now inside this ChatGPT step in our Make scenario, you can see here in between these customer feedback tags, I've just mapped that text that we aggregated from the step before. And that was it. Here's the rest of the response. And so I can just hit okay. And let's take a look at how it did. If we look at the result here, we can see here it's given the top 5 reasons for cancellation. So 1, the app was too expensive for occasional or limited use, and the price was not cost effective for users. So it's giving the exact issues that our customers are facing, and also telling us how many times this was mentioned from that set of feedback. So we have our top 5 here, super useful. And then lastly, all we're doing is sending this to us via email. So I'm using here the Gmail app within Make, and I'm using the send an email action, the way we've configured this one. So here I'm saying who's the email should be from. I've connected an email account that we use here at 9X. And now I've put in the email that this should be sent to. So this is right now for me testing just my personal email, but this could be a group. You could have a like product feedback group email that you're using. We have then the subject line, and here we have some content. So I'm saying, here's the feedback for the customers who have recently canceled their subscription. We have a couple of these HTML line breaks, and then we're putting in just that result from ChatGPT under here. And that is pretty much it. And so this has already run. We can now go and check this result in my email inbox. So now here we are in my email inbox. We can see the email arrived, product feedback summary. Again, that text that we set up in the email step. And now this dynamic data from ChatGPT, the summary coming in, the top five reasons with the mentions. So now imagine you set this up to run every Monday, taking a look at the feedback that your customers gave from the week before. This is such a good email to set up for your product team, so they really understand what are the main pain points that your customers are currently facing. You can basically work on improving this, and you'll see how the feedback is then changing over time. So no more needing to read through feedback manually, or not having even enough time to process this feedback. This is a great use case for giving this to AI first. Now, I hope that tutorial was useful and you are going to be implementing that for yourself. If you did find it useful, please like the video and also subscribe to the 9X channel. We're releasing plenty more tutorials like this one, but until next time, happy automating.